This is the fourth part of a comprehensive guide to undervolt your NVIDIA RTX 3000 series graphics card with EVGA Precision. To begin with, copy-paste the base curve you have written down during the first part of this guide. Then, copy-paste your tweaked frequencies beside the base ones. Now, if you are like me, you might want to fix an uneven pattern like this. One frequency, one voltage. One frequency, two voltages. One frequency, one voltage. One frequency, one voltage. Frequency gap, since 1770 MHz is missing. One frequency, one voltage. So what I'm going to do is reduce these three frequencies by one step to make room for the missing one. The next step is to gradually close the gap between the base frequencies and the new ones, so to have a rather smooth transition from the former to the latter. Just take your first new frequency, subtract 45 or as many steps as you see fit, and drag outside to extend this formula up until both frequencies match. After that, simply copy-paste the base frequencies. Finally, take your last new frequency, subtract 30, and drag outside to duplicate this cell until the end. We must do this to avoid issues when the base curve shifts in unpredictable ways and suddenly your max VF combo isn't 1935 MHz at 900 mV anymore, but maybe something like 1950 MHz at 906 mV, a point that we didn't even test. By a similar reasoning, take these two frequencies and subtract 15. If you don't, your max VF combo may become 1935 MHz at 887 mV. Again, a point that could very well be unstable. As a general rule, there must always be one and only one maximum frequency in the whole curve. Your tweaked curve is now complete, at least on paper. To easily translate it into EVGA Precision, we have to compute every offset value, which equals tweaked frequency minus base frequency. Now open the VF curve editor in Precision and adjust every offset using your mouse and arrow keys. For example, at 750 millivolts, my offset is 30. At 756 millivolts, my offset is 45. At 762 millivolts, my offset is 75. And so on until the end. Always remember to click Apply and save when you're finished. As you can see, my tweaked curve has some bumps here and there, and probably yours too. This is because it has been derived from a base curve, namely the current one, which is different from the base curve, namely the best one, from which we have computed the offset values. Aesthetically unappealing, yes, but something to worry about, no. Now we want to create at least three alternative versions of this tweaked curve with 900 millivolts as our max voltage. Just copy-paste your frequencies till 900 millivolts. And set 875, 850, and 825 millivolts as your max voltages. Then complete the blanks and compute the offsets as I previously explained. To speed up a little the tuning process in Precision, do this. Click on an empty profile, save. Empty profile, save. Empty profile, and save. In such a way, you will have to edit less VF points in each. Once you have four profiles with those four different tweaked curves, it's time to figure out which one provides the best performance per watt. To accomplish this, open Hardware Info and run the same benchmarks used to define your baseline during the second part of this guide. Before every run, don't forget to reset Hardware Info sensors. And after every run, fill out these cells. After completing those long benchmark sessions, compute all the averages, then insert a new line called performance per watt and type in this basic formula. Test score value divided by GPU power value. Drag the selection horizontally and you're all set. Higher values mean better efficiency. Thus, the most efficient undervolting seems to be 1800 MHz at 825 millivolts. Even if less efficient than this, 1935 MHz at 900 millivolts still beats the stock condition on all fronts: performance, temperature, power, and noise. Only Port Royal score is slightly lower. Basically, just pick the profile that suits your needs best. Obviously, we could create more profiles and test them not only in synthetic benchmarks, but also in real games. However, I believe this guide is packed enough for now. Just know that I've validated my undervolting process by completing control and all its DLCs. Of course, all settings maxed out, ray tracing included. The only crash I had was caused by the game itself during the Anchor boss battle, but to which I figured out a replicable solution. I will probably make a video about it, since it seems to affect many people. In the last part of this guide, we're going to talk about frequencies that misbehave, which I briefly mentioned in the previous video, and might render your undervolting unstable. Farewell for now.